Every 70 seconds, someone in America develops Alzheimer's disease, and as the population ages, that number will go up. Finding a cure has never been more important. Senior Helpers is a local in-home senior care provider that's helping families with innovative programs to deal with Alzheimer's. And Kathy Livingston is the senior vice president of their Manhattan location. She's here to talk more about their work. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
Full disclosure, my father was just diagnosed with Alzheimer's.
Sorry to hear that.
And you'd never realize how difficult it is for the family because the disease is so insidious that the person suffering from it often doesn't realize that they have it, and so they resist help.
Sure, absolutely. And I think what's important is what you're saying. It's not only the person facing it, it's really something that the whole family goes through.
Mm-hmm. So how do you convince somebody that we're trying to help you, you have this disease, I know it doesn't seem like it, but you do? What do you do?
I think convince is an interesting word. I think that there's not one answer for every given person. We're all individual, and we all, you're going through a role reversal. So now you have somebody that's cared for you your entire life, and you have to say, okay, we have to switch that. So I think you really need to, look at the person that you need to approach. It might be important to say before yourself, these are the statements that I really feel is important to get out, and do it in a manner from you, so not towards them. Use I statements. I really feel like you need this, and it would be helpful to me, rather than you need this, you're not doing this. It kind of goes a long way, because I think families a lot of the time say, I need to convince you, and how am I going to make you understand that
we're doing
you need
this for your help, why don't you let us help you, and you don't think anything's wrong, but something's wrong. Well, I know that your organization, in order to slow the progress of the disease, you have some things that you suggest people do, prevention programs. Talk about those for me.
Absolutely. And again, slowing the progression. I mean, nothing is going to stop this disease, and hopefully, as of right now, hopefully that changes in the future. We really believe in taking a holistic approach. What that means is physically stimulate the person. So have an exercise plan. Our caregivers a lot of the times focus on, while they're there, going out for walks, making sure that your loved one's moving and that's physically they're in the best shape that they can be. In addition to that, mentally stimulating the person, so making sure that you're doing activities. We have a little brain activity set, so crossword puzzles, Sudoku, things along those lines. And what's important to remember with that, nobody has to get it all right. It's just important to do the activities. And we also recommend a life journal. Anybody can do this with their family member. Get a journal, write in it, what's a memory that you're really fond of?
Or before that memory's gone, so that you can refer back to that.
Absolutely. I mean, that's a great part of it. It's great for the family. It's also great for the person to relive those memories while they can.
Yeah. What's the difference, though, for most people? How do you make the decision between an in-home caregiver and a facility?
Again, it's an individual decision. I think what you need to say to a family and to that person is, where do you want to be? Okay, so that's part of it. And then the other issue is, as the disease progresses, you might have more physical needs, and it might become too strenuous on the family. A lot of times where it's a spousal situation, the husband or my wife might say, I can no longer have this in the home because it's affecting my health. So you need to, as a family, assess that as it goes. I think, is it possible to spend the entire time and progress through the whole disease at home, healthy and happy? Absolutely. Do I believe you can do that in a facility as well? Absolutely. Really comes down to financial needs, wants of the family.
Yeah. We're almost out of time, but are there any medications that are showing promise right now?
There's certainly common medications that are out there, and I think, again, going back to the holistic approach, we say really consult your medical professional about that. We certainly believe that there's times where we've seen progression slow or depression, decrease with medication, but go back to make sure you're staying active physically and mentally.
Physically and mentally. Well, the caregivers for these kinds of patients are a special breed of angel. I know
they certainly are. They do a wonderful job.
All right. Kathy Livingston with Senior Helpers, thank you so much for coming
in.
Some really good information.